Good morning. Alexa, what time is it?
It's 1:31 p.m.
Shoot.
How am I supposed to want to get up with this cute doggy?
Oh, that's how.
Hello, doggy. Good morning.
Since everything's been going on, I've been waking up kind of in a haze, sort of anxious, so I like to do three sets of the Wim Hof breathing method, which I will link in the description below, and that just helps me to push some oxygen up into my head, causing a bunch of energy flow, and it just puts me in a more positive headspace before I even get out of bed. And then I get up.
Do you want to go for a walk? Do you want to go outside? Did you want to go for a walk?
First thing that I like to do after doing my meditation in the morning and finally getting out of bed is taking Sophie on a nice long-ish walk. Of course, practicing social distancing as for now, but it's about a 15-minute walk, and we just like to stretch our legs, get some sunlight, and wave at neighbors from a safe distance, of course. I'm not one of those people that could just stay inside and need that vitamin D from the sun, so this helps to keep me positive and keep, honestly, both of us going and happy, because dogs need exercise too.
Sophie, there's a squirrel. He's totally peeping out at her. Okay, bro. I don't like the way you're looking at me. What's up? I don't really like the way you're coming at me, bro. Sophie, let's go. Let's go, Sophie. Sophie. He's up there now. Sophie. Come on, babe. We're gonna go now.
Hey, Sophie, do you want a treat?
Do you want a treat? Come on, let's go. Where are the treats?
It's super important that not only she eats, but I eat a nice and nutritious lunch. Honestly, lunch. I like to make it with eggs and beans and potatoes to make a little healthy mishmash. And of course, I like to cover it in sauce and sriracha and spicy deliciousness. I've been trying not to regularly drink coffee because of my bipolar disorder, but it does help me to kind of motivate in the morning, so I just drink one cup and I pour about 1.5 inches of oat milk in there because delicious. Food, we got coffee, we got a balcony and some nice weather and a dog to help get my spirits up, and this is Catherine. Just kidding, his name's Grayson, I call him Catherine because he's a cat. He's like the sweetest cat ever, he's my roommate. Also, just so happens that just when all this crazy stuff started happening, I started to get into TikTok. So throughout the day, I tend to take a lot of these cute little videos, mostly of my dog and my roommate's cat, because they're the most entertaining things in my life. Yes, times have been hard, and sometimes I lose the motivation to keep my life clean. But I like to find some point in at least every other day to just like completely tidy my life back up. By any means necessary, apparently. First things first, I like to have my bed nice and made and tidy so that if I want to sit on it throughout the day, it just makes the room look a lot nicer, and then my dog doesn't mess it up so much by slobbering on all of my blankets and pillows.
Remember to give your pets lots of love because they don't know why you're all down and scared and out of it. They just want to see you happy and they just want some love and attention. Ah, oh, baby, what's on your eye? Get that out of there.
I just made this bed.
Again, don't let this cat fool you. Oh my god, he's so cute. But I have been spending a lot of time scrolling, and this definitely makes me a lot more depressed, especially since a lot of the things that are being posted on media right now are surrounded around negativity and the scary things that are happening in the world right now. so I've been working on limiting my screen time. However, TikTok does help to make me laugh and kind of pull me out of what's been going on. Helps me to engage since I just started my page, and honestly, it's been really fun using it. But I am actively working on cutting down my phone time just because it does help me with happiness and just being more productive. And I am happiest when I am most productive. The important thing to remember though is that times are hard, and when times are hard, it's normal to lose motivation and it's normal to slow down a little bit, and it's okay. Do your best, and your best isn't always going to be 200%.
Hi, baby. Oh my goodness, hello. Hello, baby. Sophie, you mean the... Oh, hi, Catherine. Hi, kitty, kitty. Oh, you do, do. Hi. The family's out here. The family's out here. We're here.
And another one.
If I can help falling.
Okay, but like, tell me he is not the sweetest cat you've ever seen. And now we get to yoga, my favorite time of the day. I absolutely love yoga. My practices tend to last anywhere from 25 minutes to the one that I did today was actually about an hour. And I've been doing yoga with Adrienne on YouTube, and I absolutely love her. She is amazing for if you're just getting into yoga. She gives you a lot of adaptations if some poses are a little too much for you. And she's just overall a really sweet, genuine soul and energy. I absolutely love her. I totally understand if yoga isn't your cup of tea. The reason that I personally love it is because honestly, there are so many perks when it comes to doing yoga. It prompts happiness, it promotes better digestion, flexibility, and strength. It also helps you to connect with yourself spiritually. I find a lot of emotional release when I'm doing yoga. They say that you store a lot of emotion in your joints, so like in your hips. So when you do it, it helps you to just let go. I've had a lot of times where I'm doing either the Wim Hof breathing method or yoga, and I just start crying for no reason. And during this really hard time, letting your emotions go is a really, really important thing. And especially if you have bipolar disorder, depression, anxiety, really just anything that's going to be even worsened by having to stay inside all the time, yoga has been absolutely amazing with just keeping me sane. And I am so grateful for having started it. I actually didn't even do yoga before this whole thing started, and I have seen so many benefits in my emotional health, in my physical health, and my balance. Most of what Adrienne posts on her YouTube channel is actually for beginners, and it's honestly really great content. There's a lot of the same kinds of poses and postures, but there's a lot of great benefits that come from doing her yoga. She has a 30-day yoga challenge, which I've actually been taking part in, and she actually has a website called Find What Feels Good, and I just started my 7-day trial and I absolutely love it. She includes intermediate yoga exercises, she includes advanced, she includes writing prompts and guided meditations, and honestly, it's just, she has so much to offer. I honestly love doing yoga with Adrienne because she has such a great vibe and attitude, and she smiles a lot and she makes little silly jokes and comments, and I just love her. I think that she's absolutely great, so I really recommend going to check her out. She's not sponsoring this video or anything, I just really love what she does. And again, if yoga isn't your cup of tea, there's tons of online workouts that you can look up. Just look up core workouts or arm workouts or leg workouts at home, and there will be tons of different things, whether you have barbells and equipment or not. But no matter what you do, it's really just important that you stay active during this time so that way you can keep up that energy, stay positive, and keep smiling. Ah yes, we have more to clean.
Sorry, I watched a really good TikTok. But aside from spending massive amounts of time scrolling through my phone and looking at the updates as to what's been going on, as well as just scrolling through TikTok and other things that distract me, and also the memes are freaking hilarious, I don't even care. Basically, just keeping yourself healthy, keeping yourself happy, staying motivated, staying connected, sending love to your friends and family, giving them a call, video chat, anything you can do. If you have a roommate, spending time. Really just spending time with the people around you is going to be the biggest thing, because we have to keep each other motivated and we have to keep the hope up, because things will get better. We will get through this. Right now it's just a really difficult time, But I hope you guys enjoyed this video of just like watching basically what I've been doing day to day. I know that it's not the most glamorous thing because part of it is really scary and part of it is like not being able to leave the house that much. Do with it what you will, just for the most part, make sure that you're patient with yourself because it is a scary time. It is overwhelming. There's a lot that we're having to face right now. And it's okay to not know what's going to happen. It's okay to feel uncertain because things are uncertain right now. The goal is just to take it one step at a time, one day at a time, and to just stay happy as best we can and to keep the people around us happy and accountable as much as we can. I know a lot of people have been picking up new hobbies and new things that they want to learn, whether it's an instrument or an online course they're taking or even just picking up a new book. I haven't honestly been very good at doing these things. It's been my biggest goal to just be physically active and to keep myself happy and to keep myself going because like I really have a hard time clearing my head and leveling things out sometimes. But my biggest goal is to be propelling my channel forward, to be creating more content, and to be more vibrant and more present for you guys. And then on the side, yeah, I'd love to read some more books and to learn my ukulele a little bit. I fiddled around with it yesterday and it took me forever just to tune it, so we're working on it one day at a time. But I hope you guys enjoyed this, learned something. If I do end up picking something up new to learn, I will share it with you guys for sure, in further quarantine diaries, because I have a feeling that this will be going on for a little while. Thank you guys so much. I have you now. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a fantastic rest of your day, your week, your existence. I can't wait to catch up with you guys more soon. And don't forget to leave a comment in the description below if you liked this video, as well as if you have any ideas for further videos or even just further quarantine questions or video suggestions. I don't know. Subscribe if you like my stuff and give this video a like. And beyond that, thank you guys so much. Have a great... Ugh, I already said that. Poop. Beyond that, thank you guys so much. That was so abrupt.